Hello, welcome to my talk, all about the fluid. This talk is on the principle of boundary element method for fluid structure interactions. Based on the potential flow theory, in this talk, we will explain why we can distribute the sources on the boundaries to represent the velocity potential function in the fluid, and how we can decide the strength of the sources on the boundaries. This will show the fundamentals for the boundary element method for fluid structure interaction. In this talk, I will introduce two simple potential flows, a source and a doublet in a uniform flow, to show how the simple structure can be represented using the simple source or doublet to derive the Green's theorem for the irrotational and incompressible flows, which is the fundamental equation for boundary element method. To use the Green's theorem and the de-singularisation method to explain why we can only distribute the singularities on the boundaries rather than distributing the singularities in the fluid or in the structure. To employ the Green's theorem and the de-singularisation to derive the boundary integral equation, which can be used for solving the potential function. To take an example of a wing in a uniform flow to show how we can distribute the sources on the body surface and how to construct the simultaneous equation for solving the potentials. Let's start from two examples of simple potential flows. The first example is a source in a uniform flow. Here, we only show the result, and more details can be found in my talks on potential flows. The overall velocity potential function is given by the superimposition of the potential function of the uniform flow, this, and the source, as this. And the corresponding stream function, the sum of the stream function for a uniform flow and the source. If we plot out the stream lines for the uniform flow past a source, we can see there's a long bullet shaped structure by the red line. The red line is the separation of the uniform flow and the source flow, which means there will be no flow across the red boundary. Hence, the red boundary represents a structure of a long bullet. Thus, a source in a uniform flow is equivalent to a bullet solid structure. In 3D, the potential function is given by this. The second example is a doublet in a uniform flow. The total potential is given as the sum of the potentials of the uniform flow and of the doublet as this. Similarly, the total stream function is the sum of the uniform flow and of the doublet. And this can be expressed further at this, with the R defined by this. So, on a circle where R equals capital R, the stream function equals zero. Thus, on the circle, the stream function is always zero. It's a constant stream function. Thus, the circle is a stream line. If we have a look at the radial and tangential velocity component, you can see on the circle, the radial velocity ur is zero. This means on the circle, the normal velocity component is zero, same as that of the body boundary condition. Hence, if we draw all this out, we can see the doublet is equivalent to a circle. And in 3D, the potential function is given by this. Based on the results of a source and a doublet in a uniform flow, we could imagine if we somehow distribute many resources in and on the structure, then the combination of all these sources could represent the more complicated structure. As an intuition, if we distribute the source or things in the structure, we may obtain the streamlines like this in the figure. So, the structure could be replaced by the combination of all these sources, things, in terms of the potentials. A question would be how we can distribute the sources or things so that the structure can be mathematically and correctly expressed. Or the other question would be, do we need to distribute the sources or things in the structure or just on the surface of the structure? And how we can decide the strength of the sources? In all, we need a solid mathematical foundation for such an assumption. In the next few slides, the theory why we can just distribute the source on the structure surface rather than distributing the sources in the structure is given. And this could allow us to reduce the problem of 3D volumes into the problem of 3D surfaces. Sometimes it is called 2.5D problem. In the application, the flow is assumed to be irrotational and incompressible. Thus, the flow velocity potential function satisfies the Laplace equation. To establish the theory, you suppose two potential functions, the target potential function phi and a non-potential function phi zero. For instance, from a Rankine source or a non-Green function, both potentials satisfy Laplace's equation as this. In the fluid domain, which is enclosed by the control surface SC and the body surface SB, we can use the Gauss divergence theory. So we have this, and apply the Laplace equation, we could have this. Thus, we can obtain the Green's theory. This theory is the fundamental and the most important equation for the boundary element method for fluid structure interaction, and it is the basis for the potential flow theory. Now we can choose the non-velocity potential function, simple as this, to simplify the problem. It's actually a source in 3D, so sometimes it's called the Rankine source. However, when we choose the source, it might have a singularity when x equals x0. In that case, the Green theorem might not be correct because of the singularity. Thus, we have to exclude the singularity with the small sphere as epsilon. So now we make a closed surface by the control surface, the body surface, and the small sphere surface as epsilon. So the Green theorem should be given by this equation. We can subtract the small surface, so we have the equation as this. Here we notice the two dashed line represent the connecting surface between the control surface and the small sphere. But these two surfaces have opposite normal direction, so the integrations on these two surfaces would cancel each other. So on the very small sphere S epsilon, the target potential function phi and its normal gradient can be regarded as constant. So on the small sphere, we can obtain the equation as this. Here, phi and the normal gradient of phi would both be constant. Now we look at the integration in this. Here, the normal direction and the r are opposite, so we have this equation and this, so the integration would be 4 pi. And the second term, the integration for this, we get 0. Thus, we can have an expression as this. So this equation means after de-singularization, the velocity potential function phi at any point in the fluid domain can be expressed use the potential function and the singularities distributed on the fluid boundary. Thus, there is no need to distribute the singularities in the fluid. In this slide, we will see what we can obtain for the de-singularization on the fluid boundary. To de-singularize the singularity on the boundary, now we only need a semisphere as epsilon, and a very similar method can be employed as that de-singularization in the fluid. Similarly, the target potential phi and its normal gradient as a constant on the hemisphere, and the integration on the semisphere S epsilon would lead to 2 pi phi and 0 for the second term. So after the singularization on the boundary, we have the expression called the boundary integral equation for the velocity potential function. This equation means the potential function on the boundaries can be decided by the sources distributed on the boundaries. And this is the equation we can use for solving the potentials or the strengths of the distributed sources.